Welcome to the Year of Excitement with the Golden State Warriors. Are looking forward to sharing an exciting season of NBA basketball with you. Last season was a bitter disappointment to all of us. The Warriors have been forced to live with the frustration of missing the playoffs. They're determined it won't happen again. That determination begins with head coach Al Attles, starting his fifth full season as the boss.
Last year was the first time that I've sat out as a coach the playoffs, and I think that all players concerned feel that we have something to prove, not only to our fans but to ourselves. I would like us to become a hard-nosed defensive style of basketball team in which we never concede or give up anything. And in order to be that style of player, you have to have a pride factor involved more so than just scoring points. You have to be willing to sort of sacrifice yourself and your body for your teammates. And this is what good defense means, that you're sacrificing for an all-out effort by everybody. And this is the style that I would like us to become.
The Warriors' new look of 74-75 begins with Clifford Ray. This 6'9 center becomes the man in the middle after 3 years in that slot for the rugged, victory-oriented Chicago Bulls. A fierce competitor, Cliff is well-schooled in the team defense concept being stressed by Coach Al Attles. And as a rebounder, he battles the NBA's giants on even terms night after night. Cliff Ray is a man accustomed to winning. That attitude becomes a foundation for this Warrior team. Young George Johnson late last season showed considerable promise for the future. Big George, standing 6'11", excels in defense. For example, his 9 shot blocks in a late season battle with Portland. Despite his slender frame, Johnson's timing and reflexes enabled him to average 16 rebounds a game. In one big one with the Lakers, he hauled in 30. It was only 2 years ago that George Johnson was a bank clerk, with his basketball dreams apparently very remote. But now he looks at a Warrior career which might one day bear great fruit. As it is, Dillard University of Louisiana, previously unknown on the basketball map, now points to him with pride as its sole contribution to the NBA.
Mm-hmm.
Mullins has done it all for the Warriors in his 8 years in the Bay Area, and one of the most avid Warrior rooters is President Franklin Mieuli, who has watched Mullins earn a spot as one of the all-time Warrior greats. Jeffrey, who was a Duke All-American in collegiate days, rates in the top 10 in 7 categories among Warrior all-time statistical leaders. He's second in assists, fourth in scoring, and is another Warrior star who has accounted for over 10,000 career points. At one stage, he carried a 20-point-plus average for 4 consecutive seasons. Last year, it was mid-season before number 23 found his usual groove, but when he did, he came through the final 39 games with a 19-point average. It's as a shooter that Mullins has earned his reputation. And he shoots, and shoots, and shoots. Guard Butch Beard found a home with the Warriors last year. Acquired in a trade with Seattle, where he had been the victim of a chaotic situation, he gradually carved his own niche in the Warriors' scheme, teaming with Mullins in the backcourt. By nature, Beard is a man with a zest for the all-round aspects of the game. He likes to run an offense, looks to set up some of his high-scoring mates, and takes a defensive challenge on some of the NBA's top backliners. When injuries and fatigue began to take their late-season toll, Beard assumed more of a scoring role when the situation dictated. In the final 22 games, he averaged 15 points per game and lit up opposing defenders to the tune of a field goal percentage of 54.4%. For the season, he was fifth in NBA field goal percentage, 51.2. In Beard's case, the odd timing of his Army service, an NBA expansion draft, and an organization crisis in Seattle made his career that of a round ball gypsy. Now he happily looks forward for the first time to playing 2 consecutive seasons for the same team. And for Butch Beard, that's certainly a year of excitement. Another youngster who typifies the youthful look of the Warriors is Derek Dickey, powerful 6'7 rebounder. You'll be able to follow Dickey and all the Warriors on both radio and television this season. Radio broadcasts can be heard on KNEW 910, with KTVU Channel 2 carrying the 20 road telecasts. Yours truly, Bill King, will be at Mike's side for both the radio and TV broadcasts. I'm looking forward to the year of excitement. And Dickey and his exuberant, determined teammates are a major reason for my optimism. Former Sequoia High School and University of California star Charles Johnson begins his third NBA season with the quickness, ability, and flair that will add to the exciting atmosphere of Warriors basketball. He's potentially a Norm Van Leer type of player. He can shoot it, he can jump, has outstanding quickness, and handles the ball well with either hand. On a given night, the darting CJ can light a real fire. When he does, the fans love it. And if it's excitement you crave, look no further than the classic prototype of the great NBA forward, Rick Barry, once again the game's most exciting player. An unquestioned superstar, Barry possesses all the physical requirements for greatness, and he hasn't misused them. As he plays his 9th pro season, Rick carries an added title and responsibility, captain of the Warriors as selected by his teammates. As such, he'll be leading such youngsters as number 1 draft choice Keith Wilkes, second round pick Phil Smith, selection number 3, Frank Kendrick, along with a pair of young veterans, Steve Bracy and Charles Dudley. But there's more. Nate Thurman, his former teammate, has said wherever Rick is, something's going to happen. He's just that kind of guy. Rick came to the Warriors with that knack of explosiveness and controversy, an amazing ability to find ways to score. Now at age 30, a totally rounded player, he is one of the greatest forwards ever to play the game. A phenomenal scorer, underrated rebounder, and the best playmaking forward in basketball. It was after the All-Star break that Barry shifted into high-scoring gear. He went on a 41-game tear at a blazing pace of 28.5 points per game. Over the season, he tallied 30 points or more 31 times, 21 of those coming after the All-Star game. For the season, he was in the 40s seven times, the 50s twice. And on March 25th, shattered Portland's defenses for his career high of 64. The impact of that performance falls into its true perspective with a glance at the NBA record book. Only Wilt Chamberlain and Elgin Baylor have ever scored more in a single game. Chamberlain did it 15 times. Baylor, once. Superstar. He'll continue to provide you with super thrills in 1974-75, the year of excitement in Warrior basketball.